Come on, man. I told you not to pick random mushrooms like that. And you go and eat, for fuck's sake, man. Get out of here! I don't want to talk to you! You have already made me very angry! I'm talking to people here! Don't go getting in the middle of other people's conversations! Later we talk about that mushroom you ate, okay? That's worrying what you did. But, alright. The more you watch or read manga, the more you notice some stuff. Be it some patterns, details, or things like that. After getting to know all the most varied types of stories, even if in theory they are all like that, you will inevitably arriving stories that you can say that you really liked, but that there is no way you can recommend to someone you know, being for valid reasons, or simply that you liked the story, because you are you, with your own tastes and personality, and someone else wouldn't necessarily like it, because they have a life completely different from yours. Like, okay, I really like Yugo Camp, because I really like the theme, camping, bushcraft, and the country setting. My name is isn't for nothing, right? But how many of you watching this video are even interested in that? I'm sure there aren't many, so I might have really liked that anime, loved that story. For me, maybe it's the best anime I have ever seen, even though it tries to end my channel once. But for you, it won't necessarily be like that. So after making several videos, perhaps you have already heard me say something like, if you are this kind of person, you must really like it. Now, if you are not that kind of person, you probably won't like it. But the situation is that, due to the nature of my videos, even if you are subscribed to the channel more because of me than the animes that I talk about, if you do, thank you so much. But anyway, anyone who watches a video of a random anime that I felt like talking kind of already have a predisposition and an opinion about that anime. Being small as something like, you have never watched it before but have heard about it, have seen a character from the story out there, and have a little interest, or being this perspective something bigger, like you have watched it recently, or like the work and want to see someone talking about it, or at least are open enough to go watch it at the moment, depending on what I say in the video. So that being the case, the percentage of someone falling on that video, even though they don't like the story or something like that, is very low. It happens, of course, but mostly when I say, if you are X person, you will really like it, the possibility of you being X person and not Y person who will not like the work is much greater. So as it's not our perspective, and as opinions on the internet are very controversial things, we by default tend to forget the other side and let it go, both because it's convenient and because it's something we can't relate to. But at the end of the day, what happens when you are on this other side? When everyone is talking good about X anime, based on percentage, there will be someone who doesn't like it. Have you ever thought about it? It's a pretty stupid thing, obviously. Of course there will be someone who doesn't like it. But we don't always think about that, because maybe we don't necessarily need to think that there is someone in the world who doesn't like your favorite anime. But the more works you watch or read, the greater the chances are of you finding yourself on the other side of the coin, of an anime or manga that everyone likes and speaks highly of, while you are sitting there without understanding why they speak so highly of it. Each person has a different taste. If what you don't like is the taste of the majority, you just found yourself in the minority in that roulette wheel of luck. And there's nothing wrong with that. The more roulette wheels you spin, the more often you will find yourself in this position. And this shows that everyone is unique, and you enjoy what you, your body, and your head wants, not what others want you to like. I'm sure someone who deals with psychology knows how to speak much better than me about this, but what's yours? That anime that everyone says is really good and you just don't like. I just want to see the madness that you guys are going to say. I will go first. If you promise not to pull out pitchforks and rakes on me, I will say it, alright? Okay, do we have a deal? Okay. My main one is Kimetsu no Yaiba. Yep. Everyone talks about this work as if to wear the best thing thing that existed after the invention of Salame Milano, but it never clicked with me, even though it talks about most of the topics alike. But that's not the one I want to talk about today with you. These days I have been watching some anime from the mid-2010s that were always talked about everywhere in the community, but for some reason nowadays nobody says anything anymore, and I wanted to understand, like, why? Why haven't these animes managed to remain popular over the years like so many others? Was there a deeper reason, or was just like the Haguhi FX? The first one I watched was Black Lagoon, just like you already saw the video I uploaded, and there it was relatively easy to answer these questions. But the second one I watched was one that was perhaps even more famous, Death Parade. The name alone gives me flashbacks. A friend of mine used to tell me about it almost every week, that it was very good, her favorite and so on. But the thing is, it wasn't just her. It was such a big anime at the time that it was difficult to see someone who hadn't watched it. Hell, even people who I never expected to like anime had watched it. But beauty, there it goes, Happy Pine to watch the thing 10 years later, and something happened that I didn't really expect, which gave me the motivation to make this video. Unlike Black Lagoon, which for the most part I found myself in the position of liking but not finding anything that impressive, and understanding well the positive and negative points, and that it was actually quite easy to answer these two questions here in Death Parade. All 24 minutes of 12 episodes in the special, my reaction was just this: I only understood perfectly why no one talks about this work anymore, because I completely failed to understand what this story had to offer me in terms of entertainment. And with that, I failed to even begin to answer one of the two questions I wanted to solve when I went to watch. How did it stand out so much at the time? It's not possible that only the pretty animation did that. The story goes playing legal sad songs, scenes to make me emotional. I was supposed to be feeling things at this moment, but the only thing I can do is stay with a poker face at a story that failed to capture me in one way or another. The feeling that the story wants to convey is almost the opposite of what I'm feeling when watching it, and that creates a huge disconnect. And since I failed at it, I wanted to invite you to talk about this, because I accidentally spun the wheel this time and fell on the other side. If you watched it at the time, or even now and liked it, why? At least for me, it was very difficult to care and find meaning in a world that not even the characters within it see meaning. The author kind of presents the story, he creates the problem, and then complains that it is a problem, if you know what I mean. Like, what the hell am I missing here? Nothing makes sense here, dude. How did people talk so positively about this? There has to be something. It gives me the impression that the production creates the A and Z, but all the letters between the two. When to the same elevator as the good-hearted woman who didn't want to see the love of her life in despair in the last moments. Hell, obviously. If the story doesn't want to make you believe that it's believable, how do you immerse yourself in it and enjoy it? Yes, I'm sure the vast majority can. After all, almost everyone says good things about this anime. But with Death Parade, I just banged my head against the door for some reason. How come this was my friends and many other people's absolute favorite anime? Mainly because you could see how important this story was to her. I imagine the reasons, but I, as a person, can't enjoy the story. And these reasons are what threw me off this work the most. It really gave me the feeling that the story tried too hard to talk about complex things, morality, what humanity is, and halfway through forgot what it was doing and just kept throwing impactful words at the screen to try to impress you. But I believe that it is for this exact reason that the story impacted so many people, for talking about heavy things that, depending on who you are something pertinent, that perhaps are experiencing those same difficulties that the story, even in the middle of its stumbles, accidentally managed to throw on the screen for people to relate to, sort of taking advantage of the delicate situations that these people are going through. You can understand how this is a legal wrong, right? Because of the careless way they deal with the implications of the war. I can't see anything connecting one thing to another. One event doesn't branch into another. Things have no reason to be that way. There's no reason for the characters to do that. It's not possible that over 100 million years of humanity's existence, the buffoons of the afterlife realized that teasing the dead until they do something bad doesn't make the slightest sense in judging anyone. In one episode, you already show how flawed the system is. So why does it exist? It kind of kills the premise of judging the dead, which in theory has absurd and even beautiful potential right there, because it's simply not something they care about solving. The question they themselves ask is refused to be answered by those who have the job of answering it. If you don't want to develop anything and don't know how to answer your own questions with at least pertinent things, why the hell does anyone need to be judged at the end of the day? What's the problem with them just like going where they are supposed to go without anyone pointing fingers? If there's no one competent enough to judge, why there is a position to judge? What right they have to judge others? Things that you expect them to address. You sit there waiting for it all to be explained, at least minimally, and it doesn't happen. These things for the production of the story didn't matter much. They just had the initial idea and that it would be very climatic if the trials were in a bar. And then they left. Nothing is explored in the entire anime, not even the main characters matter. Why was the king chosen to be different? Why does Chiyuki remember dying and works with the rest of the people? What does she have in particular that makes it possible for her to be there? Are we going to start breaking the flawed system like you are presenting? I can't wait to see how this develops. It's good that we talk about this guy to sell erotic fanatics all the time, instead of having a progression in the story and make you leave that zero that the story presented you with several episodes ago. Because then why does this guy exist and has an episode just for him out of nowhere that in the end doesn't matter for anything in the story itself and doesn't add anything to it, while the rest of the story suffers because it doesn't go anywhere, even with so many interesting characters? Why every random character that emerges from the elevator is more memorable and has a better story than everyone who appears in almost every episode, and are there in the dressing room on their knees in front of the anime production asking to please be developed? Why does this story exist if it refuses to tell the story, to go somewhere? Okay, they intended to make things more ambiguous, to induce you to think deeply about the themes, but it's not presenting a plot and forgetting to finish it that you cause this. It's because of these things that I kicked that guy at the bar here, man. This story leaves me very confused. Not because it tells you something that leaves you thinking, which is the intention, but because of the way it was done. What were the logistics of all this? It seems that each episode was made by a different person and that before the last episodes, no one was reminded that there was a plot going on in the middle of them all, apart from the dead people coming in the elevators. And in the end, the feeling it gives me is that the story disrespects everything that it talks about, because they talk about them so carelessly, without empathy, caring only about what will be the brightest on the screen and what will have the most keywords. Talking about things like death and self-catapulting does not automatically make the story good. All the work behind it all basically doesn't exist in Death Parade. But I think I have already said a lot, and maybe I have made some people who like it very angry, but that's what I took away from this work, and what made me think about the title of this video, and how we don't often find ourselves in this position, when everyone likes something and you don't. Even though I have been making these videos for some time, I'm terrible at expressing myself, so I hope you understand more or less what I want to explain. It's obvious that I'm the minority in this case. You who are watching right now have a great possibility of disagreeing with everything I said, and that's more than natural. There's nothing wrong with that. Opinions are created this way. Our individual preferences make us who we are. They reflect our experiences, values, and personal journey. And all of this results in what we like to consume, and also what we don't like. There's no need to try to join the masses and try to like something you don't like just because everyone else does. It's having confidence that you are you, and you are independent and know how to think for yourself.